You see, this is the closest we've been to a peace deal in Afghanistan.
Yeah.
And there is no military solution in Afghanistan. There is no military solution because, as Mr. President says, if you go all out military, there will be millions and millions of people who would die. So there is only one solution. And I feel, and I think we will discuss this, it's the closest we have been to a peace deal. And we hope that in the coming days, we will be able to urge the Taliban to speak to the Afghan government and come to a settlement, a political solution.
And what the Prime Minister, excuse me, what the Prime Minister just said is a very big story. And that's 100% true. We've made a lot of progress over the last couple of weeks. And Pakistan has helped us with that progress. But a lot of great things are happening. A lot of things are happening for the United States. And I think a lot of great things are going to be happening for Pakistan, too, under your leadership. I really feel that.
Number one, this is the longest war that the United States has ever fought. It's almost 19 years. Number two, I am one of those who always believed that there was no military solution. Because anyone who knows the history of Afghanistan, you just have to look back at the history. There was always going to be a political settlement at the end. And I have to compliment President Trump, because he has now forced people to end the war, to have a settlement. And that's where I think Pakistan is playing a very important role, because Pakistan has a 1,500-mile border with Afghanistan and all the areas where the trouble is, which is the eastern side of Afghanistan. So this is a critical time. I'm looking forward to my talks with President Trump. We have our military leadership here, because this is obviously a security situation. And what we want is understanding between the two countries. I can assure President Trump that whatever we will be saying will be the apps. We will be straight with them. There will never be any question of any doubt on Pakistan's intent, because apart from Afghanistan, the country that wants peace in Afghanistan more than any other country is Pakistan, because we get directly affected by it. And Pakistan needs stability. We have had 15 years of fighting this war on terror, over 70,000 Pakistani casualties, over $150 billion lost to the economy. So we desperately want peace. And I'm happy that President Trump has pushed this forward. So we hope, I'm looking forward to this. I will be asking President Trump. It's the most powerful country in the world, the United States. It can play the most important role in bringing peace in the subcontinent. You know, there are over a billion and a quarter people in the subcontinent. They are held hostage to the issue of Kashmir. And I feel that only the most powerful state, headed by President Trump, can bring the two countries together. From my point, I can tell you, we have tried our best. We've made all overtures to India to start dialogue, resolve our differences through dialogue. But unfortunately, we haven't made headways as yet. But I'm hoping that President Trump would push this process.
So I was with Prime Minister Modi 2 weeks ago, and we talked about this subject. And he actually said, would you like to be a mediator or arbitrator? I said, where? He said, Kashmir. Because this has been going on for many, many years. I was surprised at how long it's been going on. Long.
70 years.
I think they'd like to see it resolved, and I think you'd like to see it resolved. And if I can help, I would love to be a mediator. It shouldn't be. I mean, it's impossible to believe. Two incredible countries that are very, very smart, with very smart leadership, can't solve a problem like that. But if you would want me to mediate or arbitrate, I would be willing to do that.
President, I can tell you that right now, you will have the prayers of over a billion people if you can mediate and resolve this issue.
It should be resolved. So, but he asked me the same thing, so I think there's something. So maybe we'll speak to him, or I'll speak to him, and we'll see if we can do something.
Mr. President, even
because I've heard so much about Kashmir.
Yes.
Such a beautiful name. It's supposed to be such a beautiful part of the world, but right now there's just bombs all over the place. They say everywhere you go, you have bombs, and it's a terrible situation. Been going on for many years. If I can do anything to help that, let me know. Let me give you one thing on Afghanistan as an example. So a lot of you don't know this, but we dropped the largest non-nuclear bomb ever built in history. We dropped it in Afghanistan. We were getting ready to make many of those bombs. This left a hole that was, it took out a lot of the tunnels and everything else, but it left a hole in the earth that looked like the moon. It looked like a crater from the moon, still there. It was, nobody's ever seen anything like it. People heard it 15 miles away. They said, what was that? It shook the earth. Non-nuclear, the largest ever made by far. And they were going to make many of them. And I said, no, we don't have to. I don't want to drop that. I don't want to do that. So many easy solutions. That's actually the easy solution. And they'd come in and they'd say, let's have peace, but you don't have to do that. I think we're going to be very successful without having to go that route. And I have tremendous confidence in the Prime Minister. All right, one or two.
Pakistan Press, to call Pakistan Press as if there's their curbs on it. Pakistan has one of the freest presses in the world. All you have to do is, since I've been the Prime Minister in the last 10 months, I mean, the criticism I have received from my own press, unprecedented. So to say that there are curbs on Pakistan press is a joke.
Wait a minute. You're treated worse than I am. When they're ready, we'll be
not ready.
Quick question, Mr. President. Quick question on
you. Go ahead.
Well, there'll be things discussed, so, you know, that would be for afterwards. We'll discuss things.
We'll be discussing it. Well, I think we're going to have a great meeting today. I know that it's an important meeting. I consider this a very important meeting because I think we haven't met the potential of either country. I think the potential with Pakistan and likewise the opposite way. I think we have not even come close to meeting it. There is tremendous potential between our country and Pakistan. I think Pakistan's going to help us out to extricate ourselves. We're like policemen. We're not fighting a war. If we wanted to fight a war in Afghanistan and win it, I could win that war in a week. I just don't want to kill 10 million people. Does that make sense to you? I don't want to kill 10 million people. I have plans on Afghanistan that if I wanted to win that war, Afghanistan would be wiped off the face of the earth. It would be gone. It would be over in literally in 10 days. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to go that route. So we're working with Pakistan and others to extricate ourselves. Nor do we want to be policemen, because basically we're policemen right now. And we're not supposed to be policemen. We've been there for 19 years in Afghanistan. It's ridiculous. And I think Pakistan helps us with that. Because we don't want to stay as policemen. But if we wanted to, we could win that war. I have a plan that would win that war in a very short period of time. You understand that better than anybody. We've been in there not fighting to win, just fighting to... They're building gas stations. They're rebuilding schools. The United States, we shouldn't be doing that. That's for them to do. But what we did and what our leadership got us into is ridiculous. But... I think we'll have some very good answers on Afghanistan very quick. So we are going to, that's right, we were paying $1.3 billion to Pakistan as aid, working up for many years. The problem was Pakistan, this is before you, Pakistan was not doing anything for us. They were really, I think, subversive. They were going against us. And this is something we'll be I ended that about a year and a half ago, the $1.3 billion. And I tell you what, to be honest, I think we have a better relationship with Pakistan right now than we did when we were paying that money. But all of that can come back depending on what we work out. We're working out things that are very important. We have I consider this very important. We're working out things that are very, very important. And I think at the end of this, at the end of a very short time, we're going to have a very great relationship with Pakistan. And we should. It's a great country. They're great people. I have many friends from Pakistan. Living in New York, I have a lot of Pakistani friends, I will tell you that. And they're great people. Smart, tough. They are tough. There's no question about that. They're like him. They're tough. Yeah, we're talking about it. Secretary Mnuchin is talking about it. We're having very good talks with the Speaker of the House with Nancy Pelosi. We're having very good talks with Chuck Schumer and, of course, with Mitch McConnell and Kevin. We are Kevin McCarthy. We are, I think, doing very well on debt. If you look at debt limit, however you want to define that, but we're doing very well on that. And I think we're doing pretty well on a budget. Very important that we take care of our military. Our military was depleted. And in the last 2.5 years, we've undepleted it, okay, to put it mildly. We have made it stronger than ever before. We need another big year. So we had $700 billion. We had then $716 billion. And this year we're going to be asking for a number slightly larger than that. We're putting our military back into a shape that it's never been in before. New, the best missiles in the world, the best equipment in the world, the best military equipment of all. We're building submarines, the finest. Nobody can even think about competing with what we're building. We're building, as you know, new submarines. We have a new aircraft carrier coming online. It's the largest ship in the world. It's so large that maybe I could even land a plane on top of it, okay? But it's a big one. President Gerald Ford. It's a phenomenal ship. So what we're doing is incredible things for our country. Are you talking about from Afghanistan?
Yes.
Yeah, we have already withdrawn quite a few, and we're doing it very slowly, very safely, and we're working with Pakistan and with, as you know, we're negotiating with the Taliban, and we are doing, I think, very well in that regard. Again, it's something that we could do. We could go one of two ways. We could do a number the likes of which they've never seen before, and win it very quickly. I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that because you're talking about millions of people, and I don't want to do that. And we're working with Pakistan on getting a solution. And I think it's being worked very well. Wouldn't you say so? Well, I don't know. We're moving a lot of them out. And we've done what we were supposed to do. We've been there for 19 years, and we've acted as policemen, not soldiers. And again, if we wanted to be soldiers, it would be over in 10 days, 1 week to 10 days, if we wanted to. But I have not chosen that. Why would we kill millions of people? It wouldn't be fair. In terms of humanity, it wouldn't be fair. So we're doing very well, and I think that Pakistan is going to be a big help. Good. I want a couple of Pakistani reporters. Yeah. I like them much better than our reporters. It's your best question. So I have to focus on that because that's such a great question. I think Pakistan is going to do a lot. I really do. I think Pakistan is going to make a big difference. I think Pakistan will save millions of lives in Afghanistan because I really believe they have a power that other nations don't have with respect to Afghanistan. And I will say, as of this moment, they're working very hard and very nicely. I agree, and I think that's very true, and it's actually a very good question. The answer is yes. I see great trade with Pakistan, and I'm not talking about a little bit more. I'm talking about we could go 10 and even 20 times what we're doing right now. You know, Pakistan's a big country. It's actually a very big country, and they have tremendous product. They make great product. They make tremendous. I bought from Pakistan over the years when I was in the private sector. They make incredible product. They're brilliant people. They're hardworking people. I think we're going to have a fantastic trade relationship. I don't.
Mr. President, I have a question. Pakistan, one of the provinces of Pakistan, Balochistan, where India is sending non-state actors to destabilize them, and the people from there are going to Europe and other places, and they're getting refused, getting asylum in India, which is actually an indication that India is helping those non-state actors to infiltrate in Pakistan and to create that. And one of the guys in Pakistan is holding, which was the, you know, the leading the network. So do you think that the U.S. will be playing a role in stopping India to, you know?
I think I can very well. I have a very good relationship with Prime Minister Modi, and I think we're going to have a phenomenal relationship with the Prime Minister of Pakistan. I do think that it's a two-way street. You know, you say India is coming in and destabilizing Pakistan, but India is saying that Pakistan's coming in and destabilizing. So there's a lot of room right there where we could meet. I think we could meet. You had a question on Puerto Rico.